Spirit.
Amen.
We thank God for this opportunity. We thank God for Pastor Bachus, one of the best pastors in this country.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You can't be a preacher and not walk down the street on Bachus Lane. Amen. He's just a good fellow. Amen. We're just so delighted to be here today. I do want to say to Pastor Bachus and to Dr. Zach, you have a great man in your church who came to visit with us last a couple of Sundays ago, and the person, Mr. Bowden, just killed us, had us crying. He spoke to our young people. We thank God for Mr. Bowden and the job that he done. Sent him a couple of Sundays ago. Amen. To my lovely wife, to God who is the head of my life. There's a word in Luke chapter 22. I am simply amazed of how Satan is working in our day. The same way he worked in the past, he's still working today.
Yes, sir.
And so in Luke chapter 22, verse 1, it says, "Now the feast of the unleavened bread draw near now, which is called the Passover. And the chief priests and the scribes sought how they might kill him, for they feared the people." And here it is right here, verse 3. "Then entered Satan into Judas, sure named Esther, being of the number of the 12. And he went his way and communed with the chief priests and captains how he might betray him unto them. And they were glad and covenant to give him money. And he promised and sought opportunity to betray him unto them in the absence of the multitude." Just for a brief minute, we want to share with you this thought: the suicide of Satan and the salvation of the world. The suicide of Satan and the salvation of the world. "Now the feast of the unleavened bread drew nigh, which is called the Passover."
All right.
"And the aim has been to show that over and over in the history of the world, the epic making sins that changed the course of history never nullifies, but only fulfills the global purpose and God to glorify his son to save his people."
Yes,
it don't make no difference what happens. God always has a purpose and a plan.
Yes, sir.
Can I get a witness?
Yes, sir.
We need not worry about all this mess that's going on with this running for president.
All right.
God has a purpose and a plan.
Yes, sir.
And we need to understand that Satan is busy to try to destroy the thinking of humanity.
Amen.
But it don't make no difference who gets in the White House.
Amen.
God is still in control.
Yes.
Do I have a witness?
Yes.
Christ exalting strength in calamity and Christ courage in conflict. We need to have strength to go through some of the mess we're going through. And then we need to have courage to stand in these days. Can I get a witness? The most spectacular sin that has ever been committed in the history of the world was the murder and the betrayal of Jesus Christ. Can I get a witness? And probably the most despicable act in the process of this murder was the betrayal of Jesus' friend called Judas. You better be careful who you sit beside. You better be careful who you call your friend. Because the very person that you call your friend just might be the one that Satan is using to bring you down. Can I get a witness? He doesn't care who he uses. He just wanted you. And just let me just say this for extra credit. One thing, and I know this don't sound right, but there's one thing I admire about Satan.
Uh-huh.
He's good at what he does.
Oh, yeah.
When Satan tells his people to do something, they do it. But when God tells his people to do something, we have a question behind our mind. They don't argue with Satan. Whatever he says, they do it. Judas was one of the 12 apostles that Jesus had personally chosen and who had been with Jesus during his entire ministry. He had been entrusted with the money bag for the whole group. You better watch who you allow to have your money. Just because you say you say and you're the president of a bank does not necessarily mean that you are qualified to be the trustee chairperson. Can I get a witness? He was close enough to Jesus at the Last Supper to have the audacity to dip his finger in the ring. On that night of the Last Supper, Luke tells us that Satan entered into Judas. He went away and conferred with the chief priests and officers on how he might betray Jesus. Can I get a witness? And they were glad and agreed to give him money. So he considered and sought the opportunity to betray Jesus in the absence of the multitude. That's why we have to stay together. Because Satan can't handle us when we all get together. When we shout together. When we pray together. When we sing together. But when we get by ourselves, Satan can show up and cause some problems. Later, he led the authorities to Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane to betray him with a kiss. And notice in John, Jesus says, I laid down my life for my friend. So he called Judas his friend. When Judas came, there was a kiss that Jesus gave and Judas gave back, which sealed the death of Jesus.
All right.
As Judas sat beside Jesus with his pious religious faith and went out to cast out demons in Jesus' name, he was not a righteous lover of Jesus. Everybody in the church ain't righteous.
Amen.
He loved money. He loved the power and the pleasure that money could buy.
All right.
Satan does not take innocent people captive. There are no innocent people. Satan has power where sinful passion holds sway. Satan wants you. Satan says, the army wants you. Satan wants you. Satan wants you. Satan is the lover of money, so therefore he used that money to just act like he was a part of the crowd with Jesus. Then he sold him for 30 pieces of silver.
Right,
now here's my problem. Why would Satan use Judas to betray Jesus? Doesn't he know that if Jesus died and is resurrected, that it would give the devil his final blow? Doesn't he know that? When Jesus began his ministry on the way to the cross, Satan tried to turn him away from the cross. He didn't want Jesus to go to the cross. You do remember that he was tempted in the wilderness, that turned the stones into bread, jump off the temple and get the rulers to worship you. But Jesus knew what Satan was trying to do. The point of all of this temptation from Satan was, don't go to the cross. Don't suffer. Don't go into pain. Use your power to get away from the cross, the suffering, and the pain. And if you're the Son of God, show your right reign by not going to the cross. And notice what Satan says. He said, I can help you. I can help you. I can help you show your power. I can help you identify that you are the Son of God. And the only way we can do that is don't go to the cross.
Yeah.
You do remember the time when Jesus predicted that he would suffer many things from the elders and the chief priests, and he would be killed, and Peter would rebuke him and said, fear not. I'll die in your place.
Right.
Notice what Jesus says. He does not speak to Peter. He speaks directly to death, to the devil.
Right.
And he says, Satan, get ye behind me. Because he knew that it was Satan that was trying to stop him from going to the cross.
Yes, sir.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
It would be his undoing if Jesus did not go to the cross.
Oh, yeah.
But here in Luke chapter 22, it said that Satan entered into Judas.
All right.
Why is this about faith? Why would Satan first try to kill Jesus, stop him from going to the cross, and then turn around and say, you have to go to the cross? Why try to divert him from the cross and then take initiative to bring him to the cross?
Yeah.
Here's my effort to answer this question. Satan saw in his effort to divert Jesus from the cross was failing.
All right.
He couldn't stop it. Can I get a witness?
Yes, sir.
Time after time, Jesus kept the course.
Yeah.
His face was set like flint to die. And Satan concluded there is no stopping him.
All right.
Whenever Satan tries to stop you,
oh, yeah,
and you keep going forward, he's going to strategize his plan to divert you, to take you another route. Can I get a witness? I will make it as ugly and as painful and as heartbreaking as I can. Since I can't stop it, I'm going to make it ugly and painful and as heartbreaking as possible. Not just death, but death and betrayal. Death by abandonment. Death by denial. If he could not stop it, he would drag others into it and do as much damage as he can. If Satan can't stop, he'll get somebody else to join in the crowd to help him strategize his plan. He'll get somebody.
Yeah.
That's why church won't argue all the time. Because Satan's trying to get somebody. That's how come we have not learned how to love each other. Because Satan is working on somebody. That's why we get angry when somebody sings our song. Satan is working on somebody. Just the other day, a fellow walked in the church and somebody was sitting in his seat. This is a true story. He went to the usher and said, tell him to move. The usher said, we don't have assigned seating. And he argued with the usher, and so the assistant pastor came to try to explain to him, you sit wherever you can. He got angry, went to the fellow, said, you in my seat, and you need to move. And the fellow stood up and said, your name is not on this seat. He pushed the fellow. The fellow pushed him back. And the next thing you know, the guy that was sitting in the wrong seat got shot 3 times and died in church. Satan will use folk. He'll bring folk in to do his wickedness and to break down the people of God. But we have to stand strong. We have to hold on. We have to be encouraged.
Yes, sir.
To move on.
Yeah.
It was a spectacular his son.
Yeah.
All right. What was God's role in this sin, this betrayal, this ugliness that was capturing his son? And to ask a question like that, we should put our hands on our mouth and silence our philosophical speculations.
Yeah,
right. Because God knows what he's doing.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Yes,
all that counts is what God himself has shown us in his word.
Yeah.
And the first thing he shows us is that the details surrounding the death of Jesus are prophesied by the prophets of God.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
Jesus said to them, quoting Psalms 118, have you never read the scriptures? The stone that the builders rejected have become the cornerstone and was the word of God.
Yeah. Right.
The scriptures prophesied that Jesus must be hated. In John chapter 15, Jesus quoted Psalm 34 and said, the word that was written in their law must be fulfilled. They hated him without a cause.
Yes. All right. All
can
right.
I get a witness?
Yes.
The scriptures prophesied that the disciples would abandon him. You will all flee me and go your way. John quotes Psalms 34 and 28 and says, one of the soldiers pierced him in his side.
Yeah.
Can I get a witness?
Yeah.
But not a bone shall be broken. The scriptures prophesied that Jesus would be betrayed by his closest friend for 30 pieces of silver.
All right.
Everybody's not your friend.
All right.
You need to be careful who you hang out with.
All right.
I have three friends. Three. That's it. Everybody else is associates.
All right.
And one of my friends, my best friend, I love him because he really knows how to chew me out when I'm not doing what I'm supposed to be doing.
All right.
And that's the person of Billy Bachus. That's my best friend. I can remember one time I had an overdraft and I needed to borrow some money from Reggie. And Reggie said, now Seth, I can't tell you what all he said. Now, you're just going to give some money away. Give it to me. Because that don't make sense for you to have an overdraft. That's just giving money away. That's a friend. Can I get a witness? A friend will help you and not hurt you. Can I get a witness? From all these prophecies, we know that God foresaw and did not prevent, and therefore included in his plan that his son would be hated, abandoned, betrayed, denied, condemned, spit upon, flogged, mocked, pierced, and killed. Can I get a witness? Where was God when all of this stuff took place? He was right there where he always had been. Can I get a witness? Well, the Bible says in Isaiah 53 that it pleased God that his son might be betrayed. Can I get a witness? So I want to let you know that God used Judas as his plan for Jesus to die.
Yes, sir.
Can I get a witness? But I want you to know this morning, early this morning, that God always knows what he's doing. Can I get a witness? For the Bible said that it pleased God to bruise his son. Oh, yes, he did. And I heard him say that my son shall die, but bring salvation to the world. It was suicide for Satan, but it brought salvation for you and I. Can I get a witness?
dictionary. And what it says is that Jesus was so weary that his blood streaked to his skin, that caused the water and blood to come out of his pores. Can I get a witness? Jesus came out of a prayer meeting one Thursday, and he ran into the sun who betrayed him with a kiss.
I know y'all heard this story, but I gotta tell it anyway.
I'm going to die. So the Bachus, I've already filled out my plans. I've already wrote my obituary. They're going to take my body and they're going to fix it up. And Dr. Reginald Bachus, they're going to do my eulogy. And when they get through with the eulogy, they're going to put me back in the hearse, take me to the cemetery, put me 6 feet under, and cover me with some dirt. And while I'm in the ground, cankerworms ones are going to go down in the ground and feed on my body. And then come on to the earth, and the sparrow shall eat the cankerworm, and the buzzard shall eat the sparrow, and the eagle shall eat the buzzard. But on that great morning, when Jesus comes back and the trumpet sounds,